Picture yourself in the European Alps, a dry autumn day in the late 1800s. A large beech forest is shedding its last leaves around you, covering the forest floor like a thick blanket. Quiet, calm, and empty, right? Well, chances are you wouldn't at all be alone, finding yourself among lots of people doing something as strange as raking litter. This phenomenon was actually an important practice back then, with a long tradition, until one day it was forbidden. So, what is behind this practice? Litter raking was widespread across mountain and foothill areas of Europe, where straw was in short supply. Dry, fallen leaves were collected from deciduous forests, often by women and children, and transported to villages and farms. Here it was used as mattress fillings and as bedding for livestock. In spring, the animal bedding, full of nutritious manure, was used as a potent organic fertilizer for crops, enriching the soil. Over time, extensive removal of forest litter depleted vital nutrients from the forest, changing the local ecosystems. This led to poorer soil quality and could have negative effects on tree growth. Consequently, several countries of post-war Europe, prioritizing efficient timber production, actually banned the practice by law. As the rise of artificial fertilizers and advancements in transportation offered viable alternatives to litter, the practice has since dwindled to the verge of disappearance. However, maybe surprisingly, the practice also had positive effects. By removing the covering blanket of litter from the forest floor, smaller, more light-demanding, and poorly competitive plants were able to thrive where normally they would have been dominated by bigger, fast-growing, and therefore nutrient-demanding rivals. These newly thriving plants were often flowering species and attracted a diverse range of insects and animals, thus enhancing forest biodiversity. Today, we know that litter removal has a high potential for use in conservation practice, especially to manage the remnants of these ecosystems. The aim of the project, Rotate, is to support the biodiversity of organisms associated with traditional forms of forest management, many of which are now abandoned or rapidly declining. Through interdisciplinary collaboration in research and practical implementation, the project seeks to revive traditional forest practices to conserve and strengthen this biodiversity. Find this interesting? Explore our other videos.